Pandemic began, healthcare heroes were praised and respected. Now they're watching as numbers double, doing everything they can to prepare for a surge in coronavirus cases. Good evening, I'm Shay McAllister. Doug has the night off. Haley Minogue spoke to a doctor at UofL, learning they're going as far as repurposing a floor at one of the hospitals they haven't used in a while for more patients.
Yeah, Shay, it wasn't an abandoned floor or anything, just a floor of patient beds that was turned into call rooms and some training rooms, and it hadn't been used for patients in a long time.
We didn't decommission any of those beds or rooms. We kept them up to spec. We just haven't moved patients into there, and we haven't used it because, to be honest with you, they didn't really have the need.
But that need looming in the future for healthcare professionals.
It's like watching a slow motion car accident. You can see this coming, but there's nothing we can do anymore to stop it. We've given every warning we can. We've offered every bit of advice we can. I hope people try and keep themselves safe and keep their families safe. Now it's about dealing with the repercussions of the decisions they're going to make.
37 additional beds will now be available to COVID patients. They've also stopped inpatient elective procedures.
It's hard. I mean, the nurses are tired. The physicians are tired. Respiratory therapy's tired. You know, it's a day in, day out slog.
In the midst of a global pandemic and the city of Louisville's deadliest year of homicides, the dedication to helping community is what keeps healthcare professionals going.
And sometimes it feels like the support that people gave us and stuff at the beginning of this is gone. And that is, it's a hard message. And I continually thank all of our employees. Our staff members doing a fantastic job from top to bottom. They're very professional and they take their responsibility seriously.
Shay, it's hard to hear Dr. Smith talk about asking people over and over to be smart and help them do their jobs. So just as a reminder, the governor's Thanksgiving guidelines are no more than two households should be together indoors with a total of no more than eight people. In the studio, I'm Haley Minogue.